Welcome to another episode of Talking Nature Tuesdays. I'm Berkeley Boone. We're continuing our Halloween theme, and this time we're going to be talking about owls. I've got with me here a barred owl, and this is one of Georgia's native species. We have several that are very common. We're going to look at two of them today. But the barred owls are really, really neat species. They live in these bottomland hardwood forests and hang out up in the trees, and like other species of owls, they are nocturnal. Now, there's some very interesting things about the barred owl that make them unique. They have a nice round face there, that facial disc. It kind of looks like lines going around the eyes. They also have those very dark eyes. A lot of the other owl species have bright yellow eyes with those very dark pupils set against them. And they're named barred owls because of the bars of brown and white that go across their body and across their wings. That's how they get the name, B-A-R-R-E-D, barred owl. Now, being a bottomland-dwelling owl, they do encounter a lot of swamps and wetlands and things like that. So their favorite foods to eat are frogs and sometimes even crayfish, fish, snakes, small mammals, squirrels, flying squirrels, and things like that. Now, the word raptor, which includes hawks, owls, eagles, all the birds of prey, the word raptor means thief, or to seize or grab, and that's what they're doing with these talons, these long claws here. They're used to grip, whether it's the branch that they're sitting on or the prey that they are grabbing, but if they've got something in their feet, it's not going to be dropped or let go very easily. And part of that also comes from the fact that the relaxed position for a bird's foot is closed. Humans, you think of our hand as a bird's foot for right now. When our hand is relaxed, it's down by our side, it's open, our fingers are straight out. We have to think to close our fist. But birds are the other way around. Their relaxed position is closed. They have to think to open their foot up. So she's secure on this perch. She's not going to fall off. She's not going to drop her food very easily. Now, another really neat adaptation for owls is right in here on these feathers. And if you can notice on your screens, it's got a frayed edge, and it looks kind of ragged almost, like it's worn. But that's by design. That's supposed to be there. That is going to help break up the flow of air over those feathers and thus eliminate any noise from that air moving over the feathers. So giving owls silent flight. You've probably heard they can fly through the woods silently, sneak up on their prey. That's how they do it. They've got a frayed edge on the leading part of their feathers. Barred owls have a very unique call too. A lot of people hear it out in the woods and they say it sounds much like monkeys chattering back and forth to each other, particularly when they're getting into territorial disputes or breeding behavior. But their standard call, a lot of people liken to the phrase, who cooks for you, who cooks for y'all? So it's a very unique call, and it sounds much like this. This is a great horned owl, and they're called that because of these tufts of feathers up on top of their head. And that's just what they are. They're feathers. They're not horns. They're not ears. Most people speculate that they're used for camouflage, basically helping to further break up the outline of the owl as it's perched up against a tree. Now, great horned owls have a very mottled pattern to them, so they look very much like bark. And when they're hugged up against a tree, that camouflage is going to work, but it's even better because they've got these projections that come off of their head that help to break up their bird-like outline. Now, if you notice on this great horned owl, he is alive, I promise, his good eye is bright yellow. It's almost gold. And that's more the typical owl eye that people recognize, but that bright yellow color with that dark pupil. He does have a bad eye over on the left side here. And that's why we've got him in captivity. Because owls have these big, round, inquisitive-looking eyes, they're often said to be very intelligent, wise birds. However, scientific research hasn't shown them to be any smarter than any other species of raptor, really. Another myth that's involved with owls is that they bring bad luck. A lot of people think that if you hear an owl hooting outside your house, or if there's an owl hooting near a newborn baby, then somebody's got a whole lot of bad luck and may even die. For whatever reason, those owl hootings are associated with bad luck. I, however, think it's great luck to hear an owl out in the woods, whether it's a great horned owl or a barred owl or even a screech owl on a summer evening. It's a really, really neat experience to hear them out there.